वेलकम टू जॉय टेल्स एट लिटिल स्टेप स्टोरीज एपिसोड 10 मूशु मेल्ट्स द शील्ड। इन द प्रीवियस स्टोरी वी सॉ दैट आया नोरा एंड नानुक लुक्ड एट मूशु विद वंडर एज ही फ्लू अबाउट देम। नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस फर्दर। वाओ, आई हैड नेवर सीन अ ड्रैगन बिफोर, सेड नानुक। Me too, replied Aya. Let's not waste any more time. Step aside so Mushu can melt the shield and free the herbs, said Quahu. Yes, but be careful not to burn the herbs, worried Nora. Don't worry, Nora. Mushu knows what he has to do, Quahu replied. So, Aya, Nanook and Nora stepped away from the shield and Mushu came closer to the shield. Mushu used his fire-breathing ability to melt the shield. As soon as he started breathing out fire, the ice shield began to melt. In a matter of minutes, the shield melted and the herbs were freed, safe and fresh to use. Nora and Aya both said, "Thank you, Mushu," at the same time. Mushu nodded and stepped aside. Nora was happy to see that the herbs were not damaged. She told Aya, "Let's not fight anymore. If it was not for your friend Quahu, I would never have been able to free the herbs. Instead of protecting them, I put them in danger." "Take the herbs for Mumba," Nora added. "Really?" Aya asked with excitement. She was happy that Nora agreed to share the herbs. "Yes. But there is one thing you must know about these herbs. The Earth Goddess has blessed these herbs and they not only heal severe wounds, but also give some sort of power to the one who consumes them. I was almost on the verge of dying when the Earth Goddess appeared and gave me these herbs. They saved my life and I got a superpower of freezing myself to safety in an ice shield from any danger," Nora explained. "You mean you ate these herbs and got your strength back and a superpower too?" Aya asked curiously. "Yes, that's right. And that is the reason the goddess asked me to protect these herbs, because they have special powers. I was only trying to keep my promise," Nora replied. "You mean Mumba will get a superpower of ice shield just like you?" Aya asked. "We don't know that. The herbs have different effects on different animals," replied Nora. "But whatever effect it has will be a good one, so don't worry and take the herbs," she added. So, finally, after all the efforts and so many days on the mountain, Aya picked up the herbs she had come for. She smiled, looked at Nanook, and he smiled back. "Thank you, Nora," Aya said. She even thanked Nanook for being so helpful and kind. "It's time for me to go home," said Aya. "Let's go, Quahu. I can't wait to meet Mumba and Coco," she added. "You will soon now," said Quahu. "I wish I could fly like you to reach home sooner," Aya said. Well, you sure can. I have an idea, Wahoo replied. How about you take a ride on Mushu? He added. You want me to fly on Mushu? Aya confirmed. Yes, I'm sure Mushu won't mind. Wahoo looked at Mushu and Mushu nodded back in agreement. So, Aya climbed on Mushu, holding him tight, and the three of them flew together towards their jungle, away from the mountain, waving goodbye to Nanook and Nora. Visit my jungle someday! I'll wait for you! Shouted Aya from the sky. Both Nanook and Nora said yes together and looked at each other and smiled.